And we're live.
Oh yeah, cool. This is official.
Yeah. All right, Philip, do you want to introduce what's going on here?
Okay. All right. This is Kingdom of Solomon, our second edition. We've been trying to make kind of an updated edition, new art, and several changes to the gameplay. And so we've got it to the point now where we're wanting to show it around a little bit and get some more in-depth feedback from people who know what they're talking about. So that's kind of what this is about. So the publisher is Lance Hill from Fun Hill Games. That's how we're gonna go forward with it. And so I appreciate him, and he's around here too. So we got Ian Zing and Tony Miller and Rob Milanovich and Maurice Fitzgerald as our playtesters tonight.
All right, Rob, you're going to want to sit down at the yellow seat.
All right, so everybody's in, right? Mm-hmm. All right, so we're ready to, we'll see what happens when I push this button.
Oh, well, that would be wonderful. That I forgot that this is Tabletopia and it does not support that. So that's, hold on just a moment.
Yeah, we had that conversation.
Yeah, I forgot about that. Well, we'll just survive off of internet explorer. Everything will be fine.
Everything will be fine through Internet Explorer.
I can't believe that we just said that. No, go away.
I know.
No, it's jinxed.
The world is ending.
Now wait until he starts getting the Windows 10 upgrade halfway through.
No, don't.
halfway through. That's what's next.
Okay. Did this already start? Oh no.
Well, I think you can. I think you can get in anyway.
Okay.
At least we'll find out if you can.
Planning handicaps. I'm going to need a big one of those.
Interesting.
Your link doesn't appear to be the same as ours anymore.
Hmm.
Oh, shoot.
There we go. We were there for a second, but now it's saying it's giving you the option to pick two players. You want...
I think we're at the four-player setup.
We are.
Oh, and I'm also not seeing this stuff over here.
Hmm.
I see you at a seat, if that helps at all, which is very entertaining.
Philip, might it be useful to reset the game and...
Okay. All right, we'll try it again. All right, let me...
Game menu. I'm going to go back to the lobby.
Okay, yeah, let's go back to the lobby. Let's go back to the lobby.
Let's go back to the lobby.
There's a old Flash web video series, killfrog.com, where they do a variation of that where a giant hand comes on screen, picks up the candy bar, and takes a bite, and then the other food all starts begging for its life. I can't hear that song without thinking of that. The popcorn just going, please don't eat me, please don't eat me. Alright.
Alright, so everybody's in right now.
I see everybody in the lobby.
What about Lance? Is Lance here?
Here, did you try the link in the chat?
Okay, we're good.
I'm here.
Okay. All right, so we're gonna click this again, right?
Oh, hold on.
Ian needs to actually see the.
Oh, I'm not looking at this thing.
Is that a new link?
It is not. It's not being friendly.
Hmm. And it is the same room too, isn't it?
It's not showing the rest of the people in the room for him, for whatever reason.
Hmm. Well, we can make a whole new instance of the
That might be what you need to do.
It is in beta.
Okay, let's do that. We'll just make a whole new room. I'll post a new link.
All right, closing that one out.
All right.
The dangers of software in beta.
All right.
Well, and also not supporting Chrome.
Well.
Or Chrome not supporting Unity.
Yes.
Okay, that is the new link.
All right. Going.
Wow, it is not working.
It's not working for you. I am there.
Okay.
I'm seeing other people appear.
Give me 1 second. I'm just going to download Firefox because Internet Explorer is wrong. That's got to be what it is. No, don't make it to my default.
Now this is quality broadcasting right here.
Yeah. Well, we currently have 0 viewers, so that's okay.
Okay, that's good.
This reminds me of all the LAN parties I went to years ago.
Yeah, it's never a dull moment.
Yeah, they had 0 viewers as well. Oh, man.
Ain't technology grand?
Always.
Don't import anything. I want Firefox so I can play Tabletopia. That is all that I want. Okay, let's try this now.
What kills me is it shows you in the room. Already.
Maybe we have to kick him out or something.
And in the green
seat.
Yeah,
try kicking me out first. If you haven't already. Oh, here we go.
There you go. Maybe. Now maybe. I don't see me or...
Okay.
Maurice.
Okay, I don't see Tony.
Should be in the blue seat. Am I not showing up?
Nope, you're not there.
No.
I see everybody else. I love it.
All I see is me and Rob.
All right, I'm going to refresh my screen one more time.
This is what I see now. You can see what I'm seeing.
Yes. I've been comparing what you can see to what I can see.
And apparently...
I see you in green, Rob in yellow,
yeah, that's
Mozilla
what I see
in red, and me in blue. Right. You don't see me, though.
Nope.
Are you in the old room, possibly?
No. Pretty sure DF60NB.
That's the old room.
That's the old room.
No, that is the old room.
That'd be N43P.
How did that happen? Let me restart this and try it again. Come on.
Technical difficulties aside.
Stupid cookies.
Whoa.
There you go.
Now I'm here.
All right.
Okay, so now we can play.
Okay, all right. Let's push it.
This thing seems to be frozen up on me. Hold on.
No.
It's like, I got your problems now. What the heck happened?
I knew this was a very...
It wasn't me. I swear.
Here, let's see. Hold on.
Hey, Tony, how many people have you had doing this before? At one
oh,
time?
There we go. Oh, my gosh. Good Lord.
I had 6 people at one point and didn't have any problems, so I don't know.
Well, keep in mind that my computer needed to get fixed, so now it's fixed.
Let's see.
Yeah, it's fixed all right. I'm at 2.7 of 3.0 megabytes.
I just see Tabletopia. I don't know what's going on.
Okay, let's see.
Do we have to hit play? Or does it
start? Oh, I see. Yeah, I have to click the button. Once we...
Yeah, you'll have to hit play to actually get to the table, and then Philip will have to actually start the game.
Okay.
Right.
Once we can play.
Does everyone just see the screen?
Yes.
No.
Okay.
No.
Am looking at the board and components.
Yeah.
Oh, jeez.
And
there we go.
Reese is in, and.
All right, and you're loading now.
Rob's in.
Okay, I see the board.
Cool.
It's got Ian. It's got you pegged out at a seat, so maybe it's just.
It's just taking a long time to load.
Yeah. All right.
It might be that I'm doing a lot of things through my internet right now, and it's not happy.
I wouldn't be. So this does look different.
Oh, it's fun.
The temple, the
Levi
camp, the merchant, trader. Yeah, it's. It is very different looking. I'm digging it.
All right. And Lance, you're in here too, right?
Yes, I am.
Okay, good. All right.
You're pretty quiet, Lance, but.
No, that's cool. Okay, so. All right, I'm going to go ahead and click the start thing so we can mess with stuff.
I heard the everything starting noise.
Yeah. All right, so are we to the point where I need to sort of walk us through this?
Yeah, you can do that now. And I'll follow as you go.
Okay, let's see. Where are you? I didn't look at your screen. Are you still... Well, it looks like it... Okay. All right. Okay, so I know maybe some of you haven't even played the old version of this, so that's fine. We'll just kind of go from the beginning. So this is Solomon's empire and some kind of adjacent territories that he ended up with during his reign. And it is basically worker placement. You've got 5 pawns to work with, so we're going to take turns putting those on. And you've also got some customs houses that you can build. In the original game, you could only build one in each of these areas, but now you can build up to 3. The actual way it works is pretty straightforward. You just put a pawn on, and then you collect whatever the resource is that it says. So like if you did it in one with 2 little cubes, that's what you would get. So the resources are, the blue is exotic goods. And basically the blue can be any other cube you want, so it's a wild cube. The yellow one's a gold, and you can only get that in Judah and some other places. The red ones are copper, the gray ones are stone, the brown ones are wood, and then the other ones are food. The green ones are food. All right, so you have these different territories here you can place in, and obviously if you place your pawn in there, nobody else can go there that round. And as soon as you place your pawn down, you resolve it. So you don't wait till the end. That's one of the big changes from the other game. It just all happens kind of seamlessly. So then there's also going to be some building cards. Let's see. Can somebody put some building cards out? Just put the...
Yeah, I can get that if nobody else is.
Yeah, go ahead. And if you... Oh, you know how to flip cards and stuff, too. So yeah.
Yep.
All right. I made them a little bit smaller, but that's fine. So there's 4 of those up. The building cards, and if, by the way, if you don't know how this works, if you double-click on something, or I think... There's maybe another button that you can push.
Yeah, if you double-click, you can expand it so you can
read
it.
It'll just bring it straight up to you if you can't see that. Or you can zoom in a little bit. In addition to the little areas on the board, you can also go in some of these other spaces. Now, none of the actual spaces on the board, the other action spaces, is where you put your pawn, but you put it in the little square spot that's next to it. And because we have 4 players, we'll be using all of the little square spots, so you don't have to worry about that. And all the little custom houses, building sites as well. Let's see. And so anyway, these building cards, if you you buy one of those by paying the cost at the bottom, you can kind of see that to the bottom right. That's how much you have to pay to buy that. And you would do that by going to the foreman and putting a pawn at the foreman, and that will let you buy one of the cards. And then when you buy a card, you get to put it on a customs house anywhere you want to. And you also have an action that you can do later on with a pawn. Some of the actions, like the bazaar there with the merchant, what that does is you don't actually put your pawn on that card, whereas if you had the groom, you would put your pawn directly on there to get that action. But the merchant just makes the merchant space better. So you would just place your pawn in the merchant space as normal, and you would get a little bit of bonus automatically.
Okay, Phil, before we move on, the foreman has two columns.
Yeah.
The first one has four spaces, the second one has two spaces. What is the difference between those?
There isn't any difference at all. It's just how it fits on there.
Okay. These are all the same spaces.
Right. Now, the little words in there are just for if you have different players, it sort of scales it for you a little bit.
Okay.
Now, Lance, are you kind of making notes of weird stuff that people ask? Because that's important stuff that we need to
make. Yeah, I got it.
Okay, good. All right. So then down underneath there, the other thing you can do with the foreman is you can build a customs house by itself without having to buy the building card. But you don't get the points that the building card gives you, but it's cheaper.
A customs house is represented by one of these little buildings?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Yeah, and you'll put it in one of the rectangles on the territories.
Right. Now, you can also build roads, which we'll talk about in a little bit. They basically kind of join together some of the regions or some of the little areas. So some of the other places you can go is the trader. That's pretty obvious. You just trade in any two of your cubes, and you can take any other two that you want. And you can take really good ones, except for you can't take the blue ones. The merchant spaces, you can do three actions in the market. So that means you can sell three things, you can buy three things, or a combination thereof. Every time you buy something, the price goes up. Every time you sell something, the price goes down. Let's see. Then there's the Levite is how you build the temple. So there's two different choices for how you want to build the temple. You can either spend the expensive stuff, and you would get whatever the points are, and a fortune card, which the fortune cards just have some special stuff that you can do. We can talk about that in a minute. Or if you do the cheap stuff at the temple, you get the point value plus 3. And points and money are kind of the same thing in this game. So that's how the market works. You would spend points to get stuff out of the market, and if you sell stuff into the market, you get points for it. That's why we start off with 10 points right at the beginning, so you've got a little bit of cash to work with. If you get down to 0, you can't buy anything else. So then the other thing on the board is the turn order, which we'll kind of do randomly in a minute, and then these bonus spaces at the top. And these were in the original game, too, except we added another one. And the way these work is to get one of those, you have to put all of your remaining pawns on that space. And then because this is a four-player game, once three of them are taken, the last one is off limits. So there are only three of those are good for each round. It can be a different three, but only three. So the art gives you two fortune cards. The table gives you one of each kind of resource. The incense, that's a little bit weird symbology there, but that's it gives you as many blue cubes as equals your turn order rank. So if you're number 3, you get 3 cubes. And then you get to be number 1 in turn order, and everybody else slides down. And then the menorah will actually make everybody, it's sort of like a tax on everybody else. So depending on how many resources they have, they lose 1 point for every 2 resources they have in their little storage area, if you go on that. So the fortune cards, you hold those actually in your hand, and the way you do that in this is you just pull it to the bottom of the screen and it will go in your hand. And then you can play one fortune card each time before you put a pawn on. Now, you're not going to have enough to do it every time, but that's when you play them, and you can play one, and then you put a pawn on after that. And a lot of them do, sometimes they make the pawn that you're going to play do something special, or sometimes there's just some other effect that happens. And each fortune card has some points at the bottom of it that if you end up not playing it, those will give you points at the end of the game. Let's see, what else? Okay, and then the other thing that happens at the beginning of the game is in this bag here, there's some tiles for each space on the board and for some of the action spaces as well. And so in a four-player game, I think we're drawing three of those. And so three spaces will not produce or not be able to be used. In the case of the action spaces, you won't be able to. One of the spaces will be off limits. Or in the case of the resource spaces, that region will not produce that resource. And the other thing we didn't talk about is the roads. So if you build a road or a couple of roads, you just connect two regions or resource spaces together. And then when you put, go ahead and illustrate that. There you go. And by the way, how you rotate those is you hold down control, and then you can rotate it however how you want, I think. So are you able to do that, Ian?
Try Q and E.
Oh.
Well, you did. Just hold that, holding down. Holding control down doesn't do it?
No.
Okay. I might have had to click another option in the other thing. We'll try to do the best we can with them.
Yeah, page up, page down is how you alternate.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Well, that works good, okay. We'll make it work.
Okay. You can kind of mess them up a little bit, maybe you can get some. So anyway, what happens is if this is the thing right here, if you put a pawn in Phoenicia there, you get the two wood and the stone as well. That's because you got a little house there. Now, if there weren't any houses there, then you would still get that. But if it was somebody else's house there, you would just get the other thing. But the other person, let's say the red house was in there, you could put the red pawn in Zuba, and you could get all three of those things. Now, the roads they don't belong to anybody, so anybody can use them, so it's a little bit of a risk putting those in. And then the other thing about the reason that there's three of them on there is that if there's one, only that person can go there. So, like, if there's a greenhouse in there, only green can go in there. If there's and green is allowed to put a second house in there if he wants to. If there's two houses, every time he goes there, he gets an extra stone at that spot. Mm-hmm. And then if he actually did the other one, he would actually get an extra two if he wanted to. But usually that's not going to happen. If somebody else builds there, what ends up happening right? What ends up happening is that you have to actually pay a resource to the next guy down. So let's say the green's on the first space, red's on the second space. Red, when he went into Zoba, he would have to pay one cube to the green player. Now, he's going to get three resources, so it may be worth it to do it. And he can give him any cube he wants to. And then the blue player is going to have to pay red a cube and green a cube. So it would be a little less good for him. So yeah, that's kind of the idea there. I think that's pretty much it. The game ends when the temple gets built all the way, or when somebody plays all eight of their houses. And that's the only two ways to end the game. And then the little coins down here at the bottom are for building cards that we don't take, or the bonus spaces that we don't take. And so those are just, each one's worth one extra victory point for going on something that has some on there.
All right, let's get going.
Okay, that's good. All right, so everybody gets some resource at the beginning, actually, but that's fine.
Oh, whoops.
No, that's okay, we can... So the fourth player is actually going to get gold, and the third player is going to get copper, second player is going to get stone, first player is going to get nothing. All right, so I don't know how we want to to decide that. Just want to kind of.
Who's played before?
So I've played, but it's changed a lot. I'm willing to go first.
Okay, so Tony is blue, so we'll put him first. And then I'm just going to, I don't even remember whose player is who, so I'm just going to, oh, I'm green. I'm going to go
third. I guess I could put these in a bag, but
yeah, you could.
Bag yeah, on. They're yellow and yellow. Oh, wait, let's just do it this way, because it's kind of.
There we go, that's cool.
Okay, so green. All right,
so you get those, resources, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, that's cool.
I'll get everybody in the turn.
All right, fantastic. Okay, so that means it is. So now the other thing we need to do is look in this bag here and pull out three of the tiles.
Okay, so let's do that. One. Wow, that is no Levite.
So yeah, so that goes on one of those. So now there's only two spaces on that one.
No Moab.
Put it over like the little brown cube there at Moab.
Okay.
Because that just means it doesn't produce anything.
And last one.
I got it. Zoba.
Okay, excellent. All right. Now we are ready to begin.
Okay. All right, so let's do...
I should probably take my guy off Phoenicia.
Yeah.
I'm going to go to Hamath, and it happens immediately now.
Yeah, so you just take it.
I get a copper.
Okay. Now it's Ian's turn.
I'm going to go to Idom.
And you get a copper.
I do as well.
Oh, and then the resources at the top are limited. So if there isn't anything up there, then you don't get a resource.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I'll go to Geshur.
Okay. So you get two stone.
All right.
Yellow.
Okay. I'll go here.
Mm-hmm. Gonna go for the gold.
Go for the gold, that's right.
Mm-hmm. All Tony, the gold is his.
Tony, you're on deck?
Yep. Negev, stone.
I'm going to go on Phoenicia and grab two of wood. Is that wood? No.
Yes, yeah, that's wood. Yep. Wood all is right. Brown, food is green.
I'll go to Bashan.
Alright, I am going to go to Gilead and visit Roland Deschain while I'm there.
So now I am going to go ahead and...
I got skipped somewhere.
Oh.
Gonna go up here.
Yes, you did get which skipped. I'm sorry. That's food, the green cubes.
These guys here?
Nope.
Nope.
Wait.
Oh, are you colorblind?
Colorblind, yep.
This one right here.
Oh, is the color messing you up, Rob?
Yeah, these are different. They look different to me.
Yeah, they are. They're a little dark on the board. I'm sorry.
Yeah. Oh, no worries.
So they kind of go in order at the top, so like the most expensive down to the least expensive. And so that's the same way they are in the market.
There we go.
Okay, so now it's my turn.
Yep.
I'm going to go to the foreman.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to grab the stables.
Okay. Now, that card actually goes in your play area, so we can see it.
Yep.
So I get 3 points here?
You get 3 points.
And you have to spend the cubes back to the resources.
And then you're going to put on a customs house.
Gilead.
All right.
Does it matter where he puts it?
No, you can put it anywhere you want.
That's awesome.
I'm going to Sinai.
Well, I mean, this first person, the second person will always have to pay one.
That's correct. Unless you go to the next one, then they'll have to pay you
two.
One each.
That's true.
All right. So who's next? Am I up?
Gold is.
Gold is. Okay.
All right.
Yeah, I should just count pawns.
Usually that works, but there are some situations where it gets a little messed up. But
right, if somebody goes to one of the final spaces, for example.
Oh, we need a new building card out, too.
Oh, they come out immediately?
They come out immediately, yes.
That's awesome. I already like that. That's a change I am highly in favor of.
So what does the artisan do?
What's that? Oh, the artisan, that's a little weird of a thing. So basically, anytime you put your pawn on a resource space, you get an extra of that resource.
Oh, geez.
Now, if you have a bunch of roads and stuff, you only get the extra one for the one where your pawn is.
Okay.
But yeah, it's pretty good.
Mm-hmm. What are these guys here in Philistia?
Those are food. Also food.
Food. Okay.
Lance, that's another thing to take a note of, because that was a trouble with the first game, too. It really was not very friendly to colorblind folks.
Yep, we'll work around that.
Maybe some textures, or I don't know.
Yeah, that would probably help, some kind of markings, or...
Maybe some kind of little icon on the resource things, too, or something, maybe. I don't know.
Because I'm looking at, like, I zoomed into the Hidden Cave card. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And by going in deep, I can see the three on the right are the same, mm-hmm. and then the two on the left are different, so it's three different types on here. But it's really hard to judge which actual cubes they are up there. Mm-hmm. Although I'd probably say the second from the left might be the guys in the middle over here.
Mm-hmm. Whose turn correct. Is it?
No, it's
yellow.
It's a copper and a wood and three food is what that one is.
So, yeah. Rob, you're up.
All right, so...
Custom.
How about over here in Amman?
That's food.
Everything I got is food on these. Okay.
Philistia is two food. Amman is one food. Jezreel is one food.
Yeah.
And then there are the four spaces up top.
That's true. You could put your pawns in there.
Or there is the merchant. If you want a specific resource.
And then the table over here gives you one of each, correct?
Yes.
Arc gives you two fortune. Exactly, because that's the wild.
Yep, you got it.
And then Ark gives you two fortune cards, and then this is for the when people lose points. Was that right for the menorah?
Yes, correct.
Okay. Here, for the time being, let me... is there a way to grab multiple things at once?
Shift.
You have to hold shift.
Shift and drag, shift. And then you can...
Or you can shift and click individually.
Yeah, that's true. You can do that, too.
Either way is awkward to me. I'm used to the real-time strategy. Here,
I can get it for you. Where do you want him to go?
Put him on the table.
You got a card too, Ian. You just threw a card off the table.
Oh.
Because you still had it selected. So click on the table to unselect it.
Got it. Thank
there you.
You
go. No problem.
So one of each.
Okay, so now it's blue.
Yep, I'm used to the foibles of this interface at this point from my game. All right, so blue, I am going to build this other stables. I'm not copying Ian, I swear.
Ah, sure.
And somebody can put out another one.
I'm actually going to go ahead and play on the arc and grab two fortune cards.
All right, so you can take those right into your hand.
There you go. I'll put another building out.
Nobody look.
And then I'm going to, I need to put a house out still.
And you need your points, too.
Yes, I do. Let's do this. And then my points are three, so I need to... Of course, I pick up the whole stack when I select the bottom one. Everybody else goes at 10, and I just go on top of Ian.
Yeah.
Hey. All right.
So Ian's done, so it's to Maurice.
Using the third, yep.
All right, so you get three of those blue cubes, and then you're in first place on turn order.
Yep. I'll go ahead and we need to slide everybody down.
Wasn't that?
So, gold's already finished. Red, green are already finished. So I have one pawn.
Yep.
And free run of the place. But not much I want to do. I'm gonna put it on. I can still put it on my stables. Correct.
Yeah, but you'd have to pay 2 food to get 7 points.
Okay, so that's what it does. Got it. So let's go.
Get 2 food at Felicia.
That's exactly where I'm headed.
There you go.
2 food.
Okay, so now at the end, you put a little chip on the menorah since nobody picked that one, and then put 1 chip on every building card. No, not those. The little tokens at the bottom.
These discs?
Yeah, those. That's it. Okay, now you put the tiles back in the bag.
So all 3 of the tiles back in the bag.
And then you get all of your
pawns back.
Pawns back, yeah. And then you put out 3 more tiles.
And then we start the next round with red as first player. I wish there was a way to shake all these guys together so that they don't stay in the same configuration they were in when you pick them up. Tabletop Sim has that. This one does not. Alright, come here. Get out of Hamath.
Oh wow! None of that.
Well, this is one of the. It's one of the.
Yeah, spaces. One of the spaces.
Okay.
So no Jezreel, no Judah, and no one of the Levite spaces goes away again.
Okay, so Philip, just as a clarification, for fortune cards, you can only play 1 per turn.
You can play 1 before you place.
So if I have the card Urgency, can I play another one?
Ooh, that's a good question. I would say no.
That is incredibly unfortunate.
All right, do you think that's unfair? I don't know.
It just creates issues.
Yeah, you're right. There is an issue, I think.
Okay, so red, you're up.
What's the cost of a house that doesn't have a building?
It's down at the bottom, beneath all the buildings. It's a wood and a food.
A wood and a food. Okay, I would look for it nearer to the foreman, but I see all
yeah,
the foreman
yeah,
stuff
I
in that corner.
Yeah, there, and I couldn't figure out how to put it up there, but I think that is a good idea. I think those should be together.
Yeah, I don't see how you would do it either, but. All right.
What I would do is I would create, rather than having these lines that go through, I would have a differently colored box that surrounds each of the action spots.
Okay.
All right, let me go to...
That way you can kind of evenly space them out, and you can create whatever box you want, but it creates a very visual, this is what it does, and mm-hmm. you're all set to go.
I'm going to go to Phoenicia.
Okay. I'm going to play... Conscripts.
Mm-hmm.
I can build 2 roads for free.
Good deal. And then just make a little discard pile. Yeah, there you go.
So I'm going to do this, and I'm going to do this.
You're able to turn around, so that's...
Okay.
What'd you have to do to turn them around?
And now my turn, I'm going to do this.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to get all the stuff.
That's right.
2 food, 2 stone, and a wood.
That's correct.
which is amazing.
Now, yep. if somebody goes to Gesher, that house in Gilead sort of separates them, so they don't actually get all the way to Philistia. However, if they had a house in Gilead, that would go through, and they would get all through.
Is it Yellow's turn? No.
It is Yellow's turn.
Yes.
Okay. So what was that with Geshur again?
You'd get the brown, because... but you wouldn't get the two greens.
Actually, if you went there right now, you would just get the two stone.
The two stone.
You wouldn't get the two food in Philistia because his house kind of breaks through that road. But if you had a house in Gilead, it would connect them all together, and you would get Geshur and Philistia and Gilead.
Okay. So here, I'll do this for the time being. And that's these guys up here, correct?
Yes. Yep.
Okay.
I was going to say my death count to heat stroke alone was in the double digits.
Okay, whose turn?
All right, mine. So if I'm going to buy any of these up here, I just have to pay the cost at the bottom right, correct?
Yes.
Yeah. And place
the guy in the former area.
Yeah.
Yep. But that's it.
All right. So I'll go with...
And remember, blue counts as anything.
Yeah. I'll take this trading post.
Okay, so you automatically get 5 points.
Yes. And you can just put that little token back.
All right. So red, brown, definitely a brown, and a green.
F flips it.
Thank you.
No problem. All right, me.
Oh. Okay. Right. Oh, did he put on his trading or his customs house yet?
He has not.
No.
Cool. All right. I'm putting a foreman out. I'm gonna just build a house, a customs house, put that in the actual wood, and we'll put that in Hamath as well. That's me.
Okay, I'm gonna do the trader. And I'm going to trade in that guy and this guy. I should put these back.
Mm-hmm.
And get 2 gold.
Yep.
Okay.
I'm done, so yellow.
I could stick myself in that chest for
safekeeping. So I'll go right there. And... I'll go for the guild hall.
Oh, jeez. Oh.
Mm-hmm. It's okay. You could still build a bazaar, maybe.
I can't.
Oh, you need food.
Okay, so somebody give him 5 points.
Oh, for heaven's sakes.
Foreman for one less cube. That's interesting.
Okay, Rob, then you get to put a house on.
So this goes back, right?
Yes.
Whoa.
So that one, you just pay one less, okay. That building office?
Always build one less. Yeah. That's really nice.
One cube less, okay. No matter what it is. That's an awesome one.
Nice.
Trading post is really good. The artisan is really good. Yeah.
Whose turn is it?
Rob's got to put on that customs house.
Yellow gold customs house. Anywhere.
Where to go?
I know, it's an interesting question.
I'll go here for now.
Okay. Red?
with.
And we can still build, right?
Yep.
All right, so that one.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah. Well, blue cubes are awesome.
Well, now the question is on this, it's only after you buy it, right? You don't pay, it's not an immediate where you pay one less?
No, because you'd have to,
You have to build it first, yeah.
Right.
Yeah. I was just double checking.
And you get 5 more points for that, correct?
Yes, sir.
Has anybody given that to him yet?
I did.
Okay.
And then I build a house.
Yep. All the houses. All right. Me. I'm going to go to Hamath, and I get 2 copper.
That's correct.
That's me.
I'm going to go... Oh, shoot. what is happening to me here? Oh, gee whiz. Well,
starting to realize how tiny Israel really is, huh?
Well, it's more that, like, okay, wait, what's the key? What's the key?
You're stealing one from everybody else.
Oh, what? Always? Oh, shoot.
Now, they're the ones that get to choose which one to give you, though, so maybe...
Still good. No. I can't get that, though, unfortunately.
Not right now.
Well, I'm going to take 2 food. And that's it. I'm done.
And how was it that you build the roads?
You can do it with the foreman.
So you just drop it up here?
In one of the spaces underneath.
Oh, I see. And yeah, these are all open.
Yep. Up. Yep. 2 more spaces there. And then if you build one road, it's a stone and a food. Or if you want to build 2 at a time, it's 2 stone and a food.
Now they can't move. Can you build a road into...
Yes.
An area that has the block on it?
Yes, you can.
Yeah, because the areas that are have roads in them in the future may be blocked.
Yeah, that's a temporary thing, yeah.
Let me give that a shot. So I'll do a road over into Jezreel.
Okay.
From Geshur.
Hmm. Yeah, sorry, they're kind of too big. That's probably good enough.
Yeah, it looks good. Mm-hmm. And then that was what? 1 stone and what?
Yep, and a food.
And a food.
The one you have which 3 of in this case.
Great, thank you. Yep. That was going to be my next question.
No problem. Man, I anticipated.
Really too hard. You don't know the colors. Oh, man.
Custom-shaped meeples is the answer.
Yeah, maybe so.
Yeah, the other thing would be within Tabletopia, if you can't do that, is to be able to label them with just text.
Oh, I didn't know you could do that.
I don't know if you can.
I don't know if you can. That would be wonderful if you could, but I don't know if you can.
It would be a suggestion for them because of just this situation where someone's colorblind.
Yep.
Okay, I'm going to go ahead and build... It's my turn, right?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to build... finally, after all that, I'm going to build a bazaar, which cost me that.
Wait.
And cost me that.
Is it your turn?
No, it isn't.
No, I want to go, though.
How out of order are we? Who's next?
I think
me.
If yellow went, then it's red.
Yep, it's red.
Oh,
yep,
we're back first. I'm going to buy the bazaar. No, I'm only kidding.
That would have been fantastic. I would have probably loved you forever at that point.
I will go with the table.
Okay. You don't get a blue.
Oh, I don't get a blue?
Yeah, you just get all the new ones.
One of everything else.
Okay. Okay. Blue. Now, Tony, you're up.
Yes, now it's me. So now I'm going to buy the bazaar. No.
Get out.
I don't have any gold, man. I can't buy that out from underneath you, as much as that would be hilarious. And houses block movement to a region?
Yes.
Okay. So anywhere that I don't have that's not a house of my color, I can't go.
Right, unless there's nothing there.
Clear.
Yep.
well, I was gonna do the table, but
sorry, blocked you there.
No, that's how these games always go. If you weren't buying the bazaar, you were blocking the table.
Yep.
What do I want? Let's look. What are my plans for the future?
Future.
I'm going to go to Sinai because I don't know what I want.
Okay.
Big place to go.
And I'm finally going to build my bazaar.
How bizarre. All right, that's 6 more points for you.
Yep.
You are green. I will move you. So you are currently...
Where F, blue. There you go.
Wait, did we skip again? I'm sorry, I was studying the board.
You get to go next, Rob.
Hold on, I get to place, though.
4, 5, 6. So you're right behind red.
Okay, so I need to give yellow 1 cube, and I'm going to give you ooh.
No. You don't have to pay him anything right now. It's only if you put a pawn in there.
Oh. Does he have to pay me one as well?
No.
Oh.
He was already there.
So you pay to the left?
Yes.
Yeah, I was thinking the same thing, that if you put a house in there, you had to pay.
Yeah, it's only on the when you put a pawn there.
Okay.
Okay, I'm done. Yellow.
Okay. All right, yellow.
It would have been funny if the replacement for the bazaar card was another bazaar.
It would have.
After all that.
It would have been really funny.
Okay.
Red?
Red's already...
Blue?
Yep.
Done.
Yep, I have to decide what I'm up to here. Not making that happen. You know what? We're going to try my luck with fortune cards. Oh, cool. It automatically flips them face up when you put them in your hand. Oh, that's
Should
really
I go
cool.
to Jezreel right now? I'll collect
No, everything. Well, you would collect two stone, and you would collect a wood and two food as well.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Yes, you can do that.
Okay, that's...
Yeah, you just don't get the food from Jezreel, but you get all the rest of it.
But I get the rest of it, which is what I was hoping that I would do.
Yeah.
That's better than what I can... anything else that I can do right now. All right, I'm done. I think I've... Oh, no, yellow.
I got one more. Well... the two things I wanted to do, I now can't do, so... may as well get... some more. Hey, question on the temple real quick.
Yeah.
In the previous game, you had to build it from the bottom up. Is there any... order that you have to do things in here?
Just pretty much from left to right, so you just want to take the most expensive place.
So it would be like the 12s would go first. Right. And
that's how many that's how many points you get, so yeah.
Gotcha, okay. Alright.
Much less swingy than the priest.
Yeah.
Because I would play it very differently, and everybody would be like, well, why are you... totally ignoring that. It's like, I'll let you guys fight over that 20 points and just stay 21 points ahead.
Yeah. There is that the those bonus spaces up there, Rob. Because if you got on the incense, if you went on the incense space, which is still open, you would get those three blue cubes, and you would get to go first in turn order.
You get all three of them?
Well, you would actually get one... four, but there's only three available.
Oh, it's one per player, and then
you get it. Well, it's one per your turn order ranking.
Oh, okay. Actually, yeah, that's much nicer.
Three blue cubes, yeah.
For one pawn.
Yep.
Thank you.
So somebody will have to move him to first.
Yep.
Hold on.
Nice.
Close enough.
Okay, so now you put on a little coin thing on each of the buildings and on the manure again, looks like.
Yep. Yes, we're being nice to each other this game so far.
And then you can take your stuff back and put the tiles back in.
And then draw three more. I love that the bags auto-randomize in this.
Yeah, that's a little better than sticking your hand in there, because sometimes you draw out the same ones.
Well, in Tabletop Simulator, you actually have to pick up and shake the bag to randomize it. Which is really entertaining. Otherwise, you draw them out in the exact order you put them in. Which is always confusing. It took forever for us to figure that out.
I was going to say, how long did it take?
It's like, why do we keep getting the same order?
Man, that's lucky.
Okay, so yellow is first.
Oh, wait, now you got to put out three more tiles, then you can start.
Yep.
Bashan. Orman. Ooh.
No!
Levite. Another temple. Well... We're not doing that, so...
Every turn.
Hmm. Okay, all so right. Now you're up, Rob.
Man.
Now keep in mind, too, your guild hall is in effect, so every time you go into one of those resource bases, you do get an extra cube. You have to try to remember that.
And that's an extra from each one?
Well, no, it's just the one that your pawn's in.
Okay. So if I go into Cheshire over here... I get an extra stone, right?
Correct.
But not the Jezreel one. Okay. But if I go in the opposite direction, if I go here, I'll get two of these and then two of these, right?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And there are only two stones, so that would make think about your just. Alter your decision as well.
There's two stone?
At the top, yes.
There's three.
There's three.
Oh, okay. It's hidden behind the little thing.
Yeah, there are three stone total.
Yeah.
I see them.
Alrighty. Okay, well.
There, I can see them now. So, yeah, you can do them.
Or I'll just... I'll do this. Is that food?
Yes, it is.
Yes.
Israel? Okay.
Yep.
Thank you.
All right.
Well done.
Yes, sir.
Okay. All right. Let me go here.
Oh, that blocks just that one spot?
Yeah.
Not the... Oh.
Yeah, so it just limits us from getting six to...
I missed that somehow. Okay.
Let me get...
Whoop. I'll take that. Oh,
there you go.
just take it with you.
That's fun.
All right, so you gotta...
We almost had a midair hijacking.
All right, so some, yeah, you can give him 6 points.
Five points?
Well, he got an extra little coin on there, too.
Yeah, it's six because of the coin.
Oh, I got it. That's right.
Yep. So, Philip, the tribute card. doesn't apply right now, but I'm assuming it only applies to the territory you place your pawn in, even if it's connected by roads?
I believe so.
Okay.
Oh, wait a minute. I gotta take one of those back. Because I can build now one less, correct?
Oh, yes, that's right. That's right.
Yep. Take that gold back then.
So it's me now. Let's go to Aram and take two food. Maybe, if it'll let me. There we go.
Okay, I'm going to play Urgency. I get to place two pawn placements right
now.
Oh,
hey, Tony, I told you wrong. It's actually for every resource that you would normally collect.
Oh, wow, okay. Good to know. Okay. Now I'm thinking I should have played somewhere else, but it's not relevant right now anyway.
Of course, yeah, unfortunately.
Yep. Yeah, it's not relevant.
Yeah, I traded in that for the first one, and then for my second action, I'm going to take the stone quarry. Where is that?
Two extra points.
And that, so 5 points for me.
No, I don't like you, Ian.
Sorry. Oh, I need to place a thing on the... there we go. Okay. I'm done, so yellow.
Did you put on a customs house?
Oh, no, I didn't. No, I did. I'm done.
So then, the spear maker over here... Mm-hmm. So when you go on it, is that, what, 10 points?
You spend a red and a brown, and you get 10 points.
Okay.
Right? Is that how it works?
That's correct. Yep.
And then bazaar is when you sell, you get one additional
money
for whatever it is.
Yeah, when you sell points at the... sell resources for points at the market.
Okay, well... let me... I'll go for the monument.
So you get 4 points.
Right there. Then the cost is 1. That's the one on the left is it this one? Is that right?
Let me see. Yes, copper, stone, wood, food.
This is wood, right?
Yes.
And food.
Yep, you got it.
So it's these four.
Mm-hmm. All right, so yellow's done. Nope, he has to place
to put a house down.
I'll deal with that. You get your house.
Oh, great. Thank you.
Try and put it on a witch. We both tried to move that wood cube. That's why it didn't go anywhere, Ian. If two people try to grab something at the same time, it just ignores both of their commands.
Here I get two.
Right, you just get one.
Well, because they're trading.
You only get the extra one if you went to the second house.
Okay.
The first house just gives you the soul.
Whatever there is. There.
I've sort of tried to put those little tiny cubes underneath those to kind of hint at that, but I don't know if that's communicating much at all. I don't know.
Maybe if there was an icon under the first one. But...
No, the what I was the trading post. What does that do?
That gives you an extra cube, so you would turn in two cubes, and then you would take any three cubes.
Okay. When you
went to the trader. When you went to the trader.
Yeah. Okay. And then how do I? Okay, over here. Okay, I see.
Yep. Racking up the passive bonuses.
Whose turn is it?
Mine, I believe. Yes. All right. So I'm going here, and I'm going to go ahead and build this bazaar finally.
You get 7 points.
Yep. Which will cost me 2 copper. It's replaced by an identical building. I love it. And 2 food.
Alright, so now I...
And I am going to put my house in Zoba.
Okay. I am going to build as well, and I'm just going to build this copper mine. Because I have exactly what's needed.
Yes.
That is not the right thing. Go, and I'm gonna.
I'll replace it.
No, never mind.
Trading posts.
Okay. And I'm done. Yellow.
Okay. So then this over here gets me 2 stone.
Actually, you get 3 stone because of your guild hall. 3 stone and food.
3 stone and a food, but nothing down here, right?
Right.
I'd have to have a house in there, right?
Yes.
To do. Okay.
Okay, and now it's red.
All right. Where do I want to go? All right, blue.
All right. So if I go here, am I able to use the road?
No.
No, because you don't have any houses in there.
That's what I thought. All right, let me think here. Stupid foreman. All right, we'll go to Hamath and get my 2 copper.
How do you get 2?
Because I have 2 houses there.
Second house.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Extra cube.
I didn't know that was a thing. Okay, no big deal. I'm going to go in Gilead and get all my stuff.
Yep.
Free food.
Well, you don't actually get 3, you just get the 2.
I get 3.
How do you get the extra one?
It connects really all the way around to Jezreel.
You don't get Jezreel.
You don't have a house in Jezreel. If there was no house there, you would.
Yeah, but now it's cut off from you.
I see.
It's the same reason I don't get the wood in Gilead if I go there.
Okay, no, that makes sense. I just, I was unclear about that.
Okay. Yep.
It is a little twisty to think about it sometimes.
Okay, Yellow's turn.
Okay. I'll use... the sculptor. And then that's 10 points.
All right. Now, to go use any of these, you have to put two pawns in there?
Or all the rest of them.
All remaining.
Okay.
However many that is.
So if you just had one left, you'd put one in there?
Yes. Yep.
Right. Okay. Yeah, because I saw everybody putting multiples in there. I was like, okay, well, let me see. I get two of them, right?
Yep. Mm-hmm. Tony, you're up.
Yep. Man, everybody hoarding blue cubes.
Yeah.
All right. Just making it difficult for me to. So I'm going to do this while I can actually get one of each.
Meanwhile, I'm going on Menorah. Because all of you have all the cubes. All of you do. So I get 2 points, and let's see here. Yellow, you lose 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Do you round up or down?
It's one per each two, so you'd round down.
Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 for yellow. So yellow goes down to 26. No, sorry. 24. Okay. Oh, wait, green goes up 2. And red goes down 3.
Mm-hmm.
1, 2, 3.
And I go down, what, 5?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, yes.
Wow.
Wow, government sucks.
That was a big shift.
Well, you guys were you're hoarding. Stop hoarding.
Always hoard. Now, how do you look at the cards in your hand again? Zoom in on them?
I don't know that you can.
I wasn't able to zoom in on them.
Okay.
Can you double click them?
No.
No.
Doesn't do anything when I do that.
What do you have to do?
I don't know that there's a way to zoom in when they're in your hand, unfortunately.
You can't see your cards in your hand?
No, I can see the cards, but they're hard to read.
They're very hard to read, yeah.
Oh, man.
So I don't know what the heck I've got.
Okay, so yellow, you're up.
Well, if you want to put it way far up in the corner of the board and nobody look.
So I was just looking at the instructions, or the legend, whatever you want to call it. So player's hand, H hides it. Flip is F. Then you get a select and a context menu with left and right mouse button. That's about it. Anyway. And then,
Yeah, if you click on one, you can bring it forward, like, to make it easier to read, but it doesn't actually increase the size.
All right, so while he's doing that, I think, Red, you can go.
Red's done.
Oh, then blue. Oh, blue's done. Oh, then everyone's done. So everyone's done. Everyone can take their stuff back.
Yep.
Okay, put on a chip on the incense.
On the what?
The incense, because nobody used it.
And then just one on the rest of the buildings. You can put the tiles away.
Can only go so fast.
Mm-hmm. That's fun. Also fun.
Oh no, Tony.
Yeah, I know. My neck of the woods is getting really, really crappy.
Yeah, he popped this guy.
Yeah.
All right, then we're all set for the next round.
Okay, so yellow's up. Go for the... So the armory over here is what? Gold, stone, and then two...
No, gold, wood. So it's the brown.
So gold, wood, armory.
And two food.
Yep. Okay. Gold, wood, two food.
And you have that, so...
This is wood over here?
Yes.
And then two food. Thank you.
The granary. It's pretty cool. Mm-hmm. So... With roads, do they affect non-produced tiles, or do they care?
No, they don't care.
Okay.
They just don't produce.
So they don't produce at all, no matter what, even if there's a road into them.
Correct. But you're welcome to build some.
Diligence. If I'm reading this, it's the whole round, not just
placement? Yeah, I think so.
Okay. All right, we're going to do one of those, hey, y'all, watch this.
Well, red's first.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's correct, Tony. I just checked.
Okay, cool.
Okay. Tony, you're up.
Yep. So we're going to go here and get a stone. Wait. Why was I doing that? No, that's not what I'm doing. I'm going up here. And we're spending a stone, a blue, and a food to build two of these little dudes. This wasn't where I was going to put them, but other people have forced my hand.
Okay, so I'm going to go to Philista and go ahead and just grab a ton of stuff. One, two, three, four, and five. I'm done.
Okay, so that was...
You get two green and two...
Two
food and two stone.
And two beans.
Okay, and red, you can go. So red gets 5 points. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5... Just Wait, no, you don't have to pay me right now. Only when you place there.
Yes. It's only when you put a pawn there. No.
All right, Tony.
We're at me again. See, how do I want to do this? All right, first thing is we're going to go ahead and play Diligence, which is ignore all non-produced tiles during this round, discard this card at the end of the round.
Oh, nice. That's cool.
So then I'm going to go to a ROM here, and I will get
all the things.
And I get two copper, correct?
Yes.
Because I have the second place there. Ah, don't move the whole table. Grab the copper cubes.
Okay, and on my turn, I'm going to go to the Levite.
Did you get the two brown ones, Tony?
No, I did not. Thank you.
And I'm going to pay three... Correct me if I'm wrong, Philip, but I pay three food. Ooh. Three food, one wood, and one stone.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And I get 15 points?
15 points, that's correct.
Yep.
Okay. And I'm done.
Okay, so yellow. So with the market, when you sell, it's got the downer. What do you put it down?
You would get those points, and then you would put it down one level.
Down one below of whatever's here, or
right. So like if you sold a food, it would go down, slide down to the last spot.
Yeah, it would come down here if you sold a food. And then it would be worth one from that point on.
Those are just markers. You don't actually take
those. I see. Okay, I thought you put on here or you take
Yeah, that. They used to be like that. But no, that's a...
So it's just a sliding marker then.
Right.
Oh, okay. That makes sense. All right. And then what just happened here with the temple... So this bottom one over here, that's you get what, 12 points plus 3?
Yeah, if you do the bottom ones.
Okay, so this just designates whatever this left coin or whatever it is, that's just whatever's on the board here. Mm-hmm. I gotcha. Okay.
Whose turn is it now?
It's mine.
Okay.
I'll just go in there, and I'll do this top one. What do we have? So that's a stone, two gold, and what's that guy?
The red.
Copper.
The red. Gotcha. That's this guy right here, right?
Yep.
I'll use these homeboys here.
Mm-hmm. I assume you're getting the 12 points then?
Yes, sir.
Cool.
And then you get a fortune card as well.
Okay.
That's not in your hand yet.
Where do you put it?
You just kind of hold it.
At the very bottom of your screen, and it'll try to put it in.
Oh, it gets kind of golden or whatever that is. Okay.
Yeah, it turns your player color, and then it goes into a hand. That's end of round, not end of turn.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah, that stays out.
Okay, sorry, my bad.
Yeah, it's that good. That's why I asked. Just for one play, it's still good.
Fine.
Okay, well, this is not...
We're good. Just let me handle it. Go back to your side of the board. This is the line of death. Do not cross the line of death and stop stacking my cubes. All right. I get it. Go away.
Crashing the board one piece at a time.
Don't make me flip this table. Oh, wait. I can't do that in this one.
Yellow's done.
Yellow's done.
So red.
All right. Blue.
Any prohibition against building places with the same name?
What do you mean?
Like stables and stables?
Okay, so I could have 37 bazaars, it doesn't matter.
Yes, that's
fine. Wanted to. Okay.
There's three bazaars, and they're actually all three bazaars are a little bit different, but some of the cards have two copies.
Yep. I'm just making sure that that's not a thing.
Yeah.
So let me see, how do I want to do this? Yeah, we're going to do that. So I'm going to build... Let me see. The bazaar. Not that I was eyeballing it too heavily.
And you get 6 points.
Yep. And I get to put another... post out. So I'm going to put that... here, because I don't want anybody else. No, we're going to lock off Hamath.
Mm-hmm.
Stay away. And then, that's what I got.
Alright. And my turn, I'm going to place on Gilead.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to get all my stuff again.
Yep. Man,
we have a building card out too.
Yeah, we do. Yep.
Sorry.
Ooh, that's a good one. I like that.
The captain. Oh, captain, my captain.
Oh, I'm done, by the way.
So that was green, so it's now yellow.
Then what was it with fortune cards? When could you play them? At the beginning?
You play one before you place a pawn.
Any pawn, so it doesn't have to be at the beginning of the...
Right, yeah. So, yeah, you can play multiple during a round if you play them one at a time.
Okay.
One a turn before you play your pawn. Multiples in a round.
Okay. I will... I'll play this guy.
Inheritance.
Whew!
That's really good.
So you get a building, but no points.
You also don't pay for it.
Yeah, that's a really good card to just get the harbor.
Yes. Don't mind if I do.
And we'll take a new one out. Flip! Another monument.
So then this gets discarded.
Okay.
Oh, still my turn. Sorry about that. Reorganizing.
No, it was a busy turn.
Let's see. Next up, I will...
You could only place in Geshter right now.
He could place in Zobah as well.
Oh, that's true.
Geshter, Zobah is two places. Geshter has roads, Zobah doesn't, so...
Roads are where it's at.
He could also just pick one of the end spots.
Yeah, but there's no stone.
Yep, that's correct. That's what's making me sad. Because some people have all the stone. Like the person who's placing now.
Well, you know what? Here's some stone back in the pool.
Ah, now I don't want it.
There's two, and then that's 10 points.
Okay,
I'm done.
Red.
All right.
Okay. If anyone has a question, I will be right back.
Trying to figure out which one I want.
Now, was it that five houses, or five buildings, rather, do they trigger the end game?
No, it's...
Someone has no buildings left, that triggers it.
Yeah. If you have eight, if you have all eight of your houses out, or if the temple is built, either of those are the end game triggers. I think there used to be a building trigger in the other game, but the original, but not anymore.
Alright.
So what'd you build?
The granary.
The granary? Okay, and we got a lumber camp now. Plus two wood for placing pawns in wood regions. The lumber camp. It's pretty awesome.
Tony?
Yeah. Passives are really good. I'm going to go ahead and go here. And we're going to spend one copper, two wood, and a food to build the trading post. So that's 5 points for me. Hooray. And then just throwing it on my cubes. Look at you. And then I'm going to go ahead and put a house in Zoba. Because I don't play well with others.
Okay, now that there are four blues in play, I'm dropping on incense.
Damn you!
Getting a point.
Damn you!
And pulling all of those. Those are all mine now.
Yep. It's a really powerful move. Temple Annex. Holy crap, a discount on Levites. That's awesome.
And green is now first player.
You didn't quite get it, but you were close.
Wait.
Green is first player.
Yeah, green is first player, but...
Everybody else stays where they're at.
Yeah. So yellow.
Okay.
I'm back.
Table.
And red, you can go.
All right. Let's see. One, two. All right. Whoops. Back here. One out both. I'll play promotion. So I can remove two pawns from the
board. Wow, nice.
Pull that. Pull that.
That's awesome.
Oh yeah.
And then
especially now.
Yeah.
And now it's Tony. Oh no, you get to place one.
He gets to place one, yep. And then I go.
Let's see. Whoops.
Oh, robbing me.
You robbed yourself.
I would have just gotten 3 copper, but now I'm only going to get 2. 2 copper, 2 food, 2 wood.
And Red, you can go now. No.
All right. Well... take.
And it's the end of my round, so I'm going to go ahead and put Diligence in the discard, because I don't have any more pawns to play.
Put the last one there, because no one else has pawns, correct?
Correct.
All right. Mm-hmm. And I get 1 or 2?
2. 2 for the arc.
Okay.
All right.
And that's the end of that round.
Yep. All so, right. I'll go ahead and put the horrible curse and hate me things back in the bag and draw 3 more, and hopefully we'll get things that ruin your guys' road networks.
Nope, Edom. At the very lower.
Yep. I'm trying to get there, but it keeps trying to put it into my hand.
Well, you can keep it. I don't want it down there.
And we've got Gilead. Oh, sad panda.
I'll take that. If you drew a Diligence, then you're fine. Don't be upset. Besides, you got all those blue cubes over there.
Yeah, they're sitting really pretty right
hoarding.
Now.
Yes, he is hoarding blue cubes.
You should share those cubes.
Yeah, especially with the guy who's in last place. And last in turn order. And last in general. Just saying. Your good buddy, your podcast friend.
Yeah, no.
I was going to say, that's not going to get me any sympathy. That's going to make him hit me harder.
I'm going to go ahead and build first. Mm-hmm. I'm going to build the temple annex. Surprise no one. Which means I do have to put back 1 blue cube. But
the Arab tile is on the right spot.
And I get 5 points. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Construction 10. Well, that was weird.
And I'm done.
The Aram tile is on the wrong spot. It's on Ammon and should be on Aram.
Yes.
Oh.
It should be on Aram, on mine, of course.
Oh.
I didn't put it out. That wasn't me. Just pointing out, not cheating. Ian was trying to help me. That was his subtle help.
Hey, okay, is there a reason why we have 2 gold way up here?
Where? No, that should be here. Someone
somebody accidentally put some gold off the top of the board.
We threw them.
Wow.
Good find.
Yeah, that would have changed the game. Just a little.
Like, damn, there's gold. It's all gone. Wait a minute.
I don't think it's changed too much.
Not in this case, but...
No. All right, so yellow, you're
okay, playing. So yellow.
Left. Oh, wait, I have to place a building. Hold on.
So I'm guessing Tribute doesn't get around no production spots.
Because
it says...
Yeah, yeah, you're right. No,
instead
it doesn't.
Of.
It's what That's you would what normally thought. Take.
Yep. That's what I thought.
So what was the cost on the gold mine here? 2 stone and what are these guys?
2 wood.
I will I'll get the gold mine.
Okay, so you'll get 6 points. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You did have a gold, so you don't have to put back the blue if you don't want. That's a gold.
There's a gold? Oh.
Here, I'll change it up. For you.
Oh, thank you, sir.
And you get to build a house?
I will build a house. What was Gilead?
It was one of those.
But it does open up Philistia if you go there.
I got it. Don't worry.
Oh, thanks.
All right, Red, you're up.
All right. Blue.
Mm-hmm. What do I want to do? Let's do... So I want to do that, and that. All right, let's do... Can I afford to do that? Yes, I can. All right. So we're going to build. Going to spend a gold. Oh, never mind. I'm not going to do that. Because my houses are confusing me. Stop being blue. I was too far zoomed out. So that's one thing. Player color, totally different than resource colors.
Yeah, they need a few extra colors in Tabletopia.
Yes, they absolutely do.
Mm-hmm.
So how do I want to do this instead? Let's... I'm going to go to the merchant. And I get 3 merchant actions?
Yes.
Okay, so if I sell...
Actually, you get 4 merchant actions.
No.
No, I just get... Yeah. So I'm selling... if I sell 3 copper, I would get 5, 5, 4 because of my bazaar.
Well, the first one you sold, that would move it down. So you would get 5, 4, 4.
So five,
Yeah.
5, 4, 4. That's yep. Correct.
13 points.
Because my bazaar gives me +1 when I sell.
Mm-hmm.
And -1 when I buy, but...
And then slide the copper market token.
Down 1, yep.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I was going to get it, but that's okay. Thanks, Ian. I'm going to put it in the box. Let's not have a Tabletopia interface war.
All right, so now it's my turn. I'm going to go to Levi.
It must be.
And I'm going to build 1, 2, 1, 2. There we go. I get 13 points. 60. I'm done.
Okay, so how's this work now? So that would be...
You get 2 stone, 3 wood, and that's it.
3 stone. No, 3 food.
He gets three. He gets three stone because of his artisan.
Right, right.
He gets one
here.
Food there, and the two food from Philistia, but he doesn't get anything from Gilead. Right.
So and that's only because of. That's only because of the block here, right?
Correct. That is correct.
Okay. So it's three stone, three food.
Three food. Yep.
All right, Red, you're up.
All right.
You took my food.
There's plenty more to go around.
Maybe.
There isn't.
Oh, wait. How many do you...
He's taking...
I was starting it.
So he needs three food and three stone.
Okay.
Leaving two left behind, I believe.
You're a food thief. All right.
All right.
I'm
so,
a little slow with my food.
Tony, you're up.
So are those two food actually there, or do those go to Red?
Yes, so that's
what going to be now.
Okay. Good to know. So I'm going to go to Hamath. I'm going to go ahead and take my three coffers back. Just watch me. And then I also get two wood. Oh, I hate it when it does that.
You generously give your copper to Ian.
And now it's my turn.
I'm not that generous.
I'm going to go fight again, and I'm going to put some stuff back in the pool. And I get another 13 points. I'm done.
Alright. So we are at yellow. With his massive resource hoard.
Yes. And I don't know what I'm going to do with all that food.
Get menorah.
So.
You guys can menorah all you want, right? I don't care.
Blue resource hoarder.
So what was on the bottom here in the temple? So that was stone,
wood, and three food.
Three food.
That's a good thing to do with food.
Yes.
Well, you don't have a wood, though.
He has a blue.
Got the blue.
He has a blue.
The blue homeboy.
Yes, all the blues, you know, that everybody else has been hoarding all game.
So, here. I'll do that. Then the stone. Okay. Big decision here. I'll go for the 9. So that's what? 9, 12 total.
Mm-hmm. Man, that one yellow house has wrecked me. It's hilarious.
It seems like everything right here, if you just control here, you just get to dominate.
Yeah, that one...
There's some other dominating positions.
Oh, yeah. If I'd started in Zobah instead of Hamath, that wouldn't have been bad, but I can't believe nobody's built into Judah yet.
Well, no, I'm surprised what roads haven't
been. That's what I'm saying. No roads at all. No. Because everybody doesn't want everybody to have gold. So are we on me?
Who just went?
That's a good question. I think it was gold just built on the temple.
Okay, gold did, all right.
Yeah. So it's you now.
All right, let's see.
Sorry, I lost complete track of who I was.
Now, if I went into the gap, if I placed a pawn in here, how does this work out? I have to pay one?
Yeah, you would collect your stuff, and then you would pay one cube of your choice of anything from your stock.
Okay. That's what I was checking. All right.
Excuse me.
And pay that to just the bank or to the player?
Ian.
You're going to give it to me?
But there you go.
Thanks.
There you go.
Don't say he never gave you anything.
Yeah, exactly.
That's very generous right there.
Well, I'm a nice guy like that.
It seems that way. All right, so if I go to the merchant and sell 3 copper, I get 12. Is it 12? Yeah,
yes.
12 more points. Why do I feel like I've built a produce-consume engine like in Race for the Galaxy?
I'm going to go ahead and build a monument. And I'm going to get 5 points. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm done.
A guild hall. It's another artisan action. That's a sweet action.
Yellow, you're up.
Okay, I'm doing my monument. To stone, that's 10 points.
You're at 80. Oh, oops, I forgot. I need to build a building.
Oh, silly me.
Red.
All right, I'll go here.
And blue.
So if I go to Aram, all my roads still work?
Yes.
Yes.
So I will get my 3 copper, and I'll get the 1 wood that's in there.
Yes.
For what that's worth. Okay.
I think I'm going to have to, go ahead and do this, I think. I could take a risk here. I think I'm going to prevent you guys from getting the arc. Okay, I'm done.
You can see your cards. No, not that one, the other one.
Well, if you could see the card that's in my hand, you would see how totally useless it is.
Who's up, yellow?
Yes.
Right? Okay.
Yes.
Yeah, Ian yeah, just did the arc, so.
So I will go over. Oh no, no, I'm not gonna do that. What are the colors on the spear maker on the armory? Is that what?
It
red
is
and
red and brown.
Okay. Don't have the wood.
Now
I
do
wish
that.
I had a spear maker.
What do you do to do that? Where do you put the pawn?
You put it on the
card. Put it on the card. Okay.
Yep. Yeah, I wish I could.
Well,
I have a lot of both of those color cubes. But I didn't get a spear maker. And the most there is of any card is two in the deck, right?
Yeah, that's right.
So, both of them are already purchased, so I cannot get one this game.
And then if I go over here onto Jezreel,
mm-hmm.
would that stop green. At Kishore?
No, you'd get all of them.
So it would still go all the way through, yeah. right?
Yep. Yeah, you just... Mm-hmm. Because you have houses in all those areas, yeah. you just wouldn't get any wood from Gilead.
Right.
Well, you wouldn't get any wood from Gilead because someone's...
Yeah.
None.
I'm not hoarding it. I'm trying to find a use for it.
So right. So then I would get what? 1, 2, 3, 4 food and 2 stone?
Yep.
I'll do that.
There's all this...
Okay, Red, you're up.
Alrighty. Let's see. How many? No. Okay. I'll take. Oh, wait, no, I won't. That's not enough there. Okay. Do I have one? All right.
Am I placing last this round?
Yes.
Okay, it looks like it. Oh, and we need a building card. A planning office. Wow.
Building costs one less resource.
Yeah, oh yeah, that's right. Hold on. Okay.
All right. So me. Trying to think if there's a reason not to go with obvious produce ton of points or if I should try to grab some more stuff right now. It's one of those, if I do that, will it get me 12 points over the course of the game or should I just take 12 points now? I think 12 points now is probably the best bet looking at how quickly the temple's filling up. Because it's... Well, I guess it can't end next round.
It could.
Or somebody could build 2 houses.
Well, yeah. I'm just saying the temple... There's only 3 spaces to build.
You can't fill up the temple next round, that's correct.
Unless there's some fortune card that lets people build on the temple.
Yeah, I don't think there is.
Or a Levite camp card. No. Like the promo from the original. Yeah. Alright, we're not going to agonize over it anymore. Let's just go ahead and go to the merchant. Not my hand. Oh, pawn. Things at the bottom of my screen do not like me. Merchant, and we're selling 3 copper for another 12 points.
Okay, and now we're done. Wow.
And Aram goes back in the bag. And Gilead goes back in the bag. And where's the third one? You already got it? All right, yeah. So I'll draw the new three.
I got Gilead. Oh, Gilead again. Moab.
Which is down there.
And Basharn.
Which I just covered up.
Yeah. All right. Wow, no wood this round. That's cool.
Well, you can't get it in anyway.
Yeah. Yeah, you're not getting it anywhere, so.
All right. First things first, I am doing exactly what it's already out there, and I am building. I'm doing a Levite. And I get 9 points. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And I get a fortune card. Okay.
All right.
And I'm done.
Okay, I will. Did we put down the new tokens?
Yes. I wasn't
paying attention.
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I just noticed this one was blacked again. All right.
Still
so,
is.
Yeah.
Yep. All the wood, all the time.
Yeah. Oh, so that's what you guys are talking about.
Okay. Yeah.
I will go to. Let's do my sculptor.
Blue? Sorry, red.
All right.
Blue?
Trader, and I'm going to trade two of this wood. For 3 stone.
Okay. I'm gonna go on my mason and get 2 stone. I'm done. Yellow.
Do trader. We'll trade in. To food. For 2 wood.
Are you done?
Yes.
Okay, Red. Tony?
All right, let's go. I don't want to do this. Yeah, I want to do it this way, so let's get... And...
I'm going to go into Gilead. I'm going to get the rest of this stuff. And Yellow's turn.
I wanted some of that stuff.
No, too bad.
You can blame me. It's all my fault.
All right, then. Well,
yeah, Tony, what the hell?
Go over...
Trying to break the game.
No.
I'm just kidding.
Yes, but no.
So the bottom one here, that was 3 food, wood, and stone, right?
Correct.
Great.
3 food, 1 wood, and stone. Mm-hmm. So nice, giving everybody resources back.
Right there. Yep, 101.
So, red now.
All right. And 14.
So, 59. Cool.
Blue?
Yep. Merchant. 3 merchant actions. I'm going to go ahead and sell 1 gold for 5, and then 2 coppers each for
3
each, which will be...
4 each.
4 each, yeah. 4 each. So 8 and 5, 13 points from... 39 to 49 to 52.
I'm gonna build a Levite as well.
Imagine that.
And I get a comparable number of points, I think. 11?
11.
11. What color is Spearmaker again? Is that red and...
And brown.
Red and brown.
These are all wonky because there's so many of them missing.
Philip, I'm seeing a noted problem here.
Who said that?
That's Ian.
Okay, yeah.
Both Rob and I are basically fighting right now, and neither of us really wants to end the game. I don't mind
ending it if I'm in front of you.
That's true.
And I'm a lover, not a hater, by the way.
Yeah. Okay. All right.
First things first. Play that wisdom card. I love watching all the hands go over to read it.
Okay. And which one are you doing?
I'll take... actually, no, I'll take gold.
Oh, Judah. All
right. Okay. And then what I'll do is Foundry.
Nice. All right. Blue.
Merchant. In this case, I'm going to sell two coppers and a stone for 12 points. Stone goes down one.
And the game end triggers at the end of a round, right?
Well, you finish the round.
Okay.
Yeah, that's when you check. You check at the end of the round.
Okay, I'm going to go ahead and grab this, so I get a point. And one of each. I'm done.
Well, there's one of each in stock.
Yeah.
Let's see, Geshur or Ark? Geshur or Ark? I think I'll go here. So, three wood.
Right? There's only two four. Stone and... Or, sorry, three food. You would get three food and three stone.
Yes. Three.
There are only two stone in play, so you would get two stone and three food for that.
You know what? Let me move it here, then.
And then you would get four food and two stone.
Two stone. Okay.
Yep.
That works better.
Phil, you have to resolve the fortune cards before...
Yeah, before you play your pawn.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. All right. So that was gold. So red. Oh, I really don't like you right now.
So you get one.
I really don't like you right now.
I get 1 point for that, right?
Yep.
Okay. And then I get...
Oh, that happens at the end of the round, doesn't it?
What's that?
The incense?
Well, I think it can happen immediately. How bad of it is it if we do it immediately?
There are just some wonky interactions with some of the cards that allow you, like some of the fortune cards that allow you to take back some stuff.
Oh, so you leave that disc over there, the coin?
I mean, we can give him the point, right?
Mm-hmm.
For the disc?
Try and see what happens.
All right.
Well, I mean, it's not going to really affect it now, but just that's going to come up eventually.
I mean, we've been sort of trying to think about examples of that, and there may be a few. I don't know.
Yeah, that wrecks me. I don't even know what I want to do with this last pawn.
Grab the arc.
Yeah. Get some fortune cookies.
And pray. No, I was hoping to go first next turn, but now I'm basically out of the running. That basically ended my game. So, what do I want to do now? Fortune cards is probably the best bet, because I don't have the resources to build anything now because I sold them all off. I could sell off a ton more resources. Well, three more resources, but the most I could get is 9 points. What's the average point value of a fortune card?
The face value goes from 5 to 1, and then depending on what else you can bring out of it.
Right.
Actually, there may still be some tens in there, but I can't remember. I don't think there are, but there might be.
You know what? At this point, we'll Hail Mary. I'll take the fortune cards.
All right, and so now we can reorder.
Yeah, these fortune cards are not going to be played. There's not enough resources to even bother.
Now, I don't know if I mentioned this or not, but I think it was my intention, and this is the way it was in the other game, that you would get 1 point for every resource you have at the end of the game as well.
Well, that's probably the only hope in hell I have. And it's still not going to get me out of last place, I don't think.
Where the heck did my other pawns go?
I ate them. You don't need them.
Did I put them in a bag by accident?
They're on your cards.
I hope not.
Oh, there you go.
They're on the cards. I hope not.
No, because I had moved them so many times, every time you move over it, it opens up. I was like, crap.
Oh, my gosh. Come on again. Gesher. And merchant.
Oh.
I can't read the value on this card. Nobody look up over in my corner.
Oh, no. That one.
Yeah.
I say, so red, you're up first. In that case, I'm just going to play this now. And that gives me 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 points. And then I can do an action. I'm gonna Levite, I think. So
imagine that.
This thing. That thing.
That covers up one of the 2 7s.
Huh?
Does that cover up one of the 2 7s?
Yes.
Sorry, I've been completely ignoring the temple, so I have no idea where we were at.
Okay, yellow, you're up.
Okay. I'll trade 2 food. For stone and a wood. Whoa. I'm done.
Man. I'm gonna go to my stables and get rid of 2 food for 7 points.
Okay.
Which takes me from 52 to 59. I'm just hoping not to get lapped at this point.
We love you, Tony.
Hey, it's my goal, is to not get lapped. That's my new victory condition for myself. Not get lapped. if I can manage that, then it's been a good game.
That's the kind of playtesters I'm looking for.
All right, so green, my turn. I think I'm going to finish the Levite Temple.
Oh.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Because I can do green, green, brown.
No, you can't.
Yep.
No, you can't.
Yeah, I can.
I have a card that says you can't.
Oh.
Oh, I should have done that. Wasn't paying attention to my cards. Because I could have actually.
It gives me 10 points.
Now, does that mean we finish out the round?
Yeah, or you finish out the round. That's it.
Because I could have stopped you with this damn card, but I wasn't paying attention.
Okay. Well, I'll go here for my 2-stone.
So, question for adjacency.
Yep.
Judah is not adjacent to Ammon or Moab, right?
That's correct.
Okay. I figured the water broke that up, but I remember it did in the previous one, but I wanted to make sure.
I did have some people trying to build roads through the Dead Sea, but...
Well, if you're good enough, if you're in good enough standing with He on Most High, you might get a temporary road, but...
Well, heck, if you can build not bridges out there, why not tunnels, right?
Oh, that would be a great fortune card.
Wrong time period. This is way later. But fun. So let's see. What do I want to do? Is it me? Or am I speculating early?
Nope. Yes.
It's you.
It's you.
Okay.
Don't get lapped. Don't get lapped.
Yeah, I know. Every single one is how many points can I get? How many points can I get? Let's see. That nets me. Let's see, so if I do that, that will get me that, which isn't that big of a benefit. So you said each cube is one.
Yes.
At the end, okay.
Yeah.
Meaning, selling them in the market for me is actually better. So I should just try to offload as much of this shit as possible.
Yep.
and then menorah, like my life depends on it. It's not gonna matter. Okay, so we're gonna do this, and actually, let's do this because it's meaner, and then. Not much meaner, but slightly meaner. And then uno, dos, y tres.
Hey,
all right.
You're up.
That's me.
My turn?
Yeah, green.
Yep, freeze, but that's it. Okay, I'm done.
Okay, if going into Jezreel over here, that would be
one food,
yeah.
One food and nothing else?
No, because there's nothing else there.
Oh, yeah.
There's no other food. You're welcome.
There was some wood up there a little while ago, but...
Yeah, no, Tony took that.
Yeah. Okay, well... Plan B.
I've got to do something.
You deforested everything.
Even if it's just take all of the resources. I've got to do something.
Well, then I will
sell it all. Buy more and sell it all off.
Unfortunately, it's not as efficient.
Points is points.
Because selling it off, it is, but it's two actions for the points instead of one action for the points. So if there's anything you can do that's just one action, then it's good.
But I did kind of nuke the points in the market a little bit too, which I don't know if that's the right decision or not, but one of the things we're looking at.
Yeah, nobody's bought resources.
No. There's no reason to.
Nope.
Especially not with the blues in the game.
Mm-hmm.
Whose turn is it?
Yellow's done, so blue.
Me.
So.
I'm sitting here jacking my jaw. Yeah, I could sell, or I could just go grab more.
You can go grab more. That's what I'd do.
Trying to think how entertaining this is going to be. So if I use Tribute, it turns all of the resources I collect into blue?
Yes.
That's not as good in this circumstance. It would be very entertaining, but... although, what am I even getting? If I go up there, I would get one food and three copper, meaning there's no more copper and no more food for anybody else. That sounds like a real jerk move.
You bastard. Hey, yeah. But at the end, it's points, right?
Mm-hmm.
It is.
So it's a valid move.
It is. I can also try and sell some of it off at the end, since I'm going to be playing the last pawn, probably. But well, it's...
Okay, so now it's Red's turn while he's doing that.
Just not being lapped.
Here, have another red.
Oh, there's more I can collect, sure.
Not right now.
Oh, I know. No, I'm not going to collect any more resources at this point.
See, I need another damn turn. Well, two turns.
I'm done. Yellow.
All right. I'll do my armory. Right, that's
that's right.
Okay.
What are the bonus spaces?
That's the four things, the Ark and Table and Menorah and Incense.
Okay.
Should probably...
And
I need a label.
Again.
Okay, it's you're done?
Yep.
Alright. Damn.
Tony?
I am... Let's see, I'm gonna go... You know what? We'll sell some stuff. Three coppers, which will get me... 12 points.
I still can't do that. Just to do something. Oh, I know what I should have done.
Did you get your 12 points, Tony?
I'm gonna do this.
Unless somebody else moved me, no. No. Let me do that now. So 59 to... 69 to 71.
Okay, and my last turn, I'm going to sculpt some stuff. And get 10 more points. I'm at 32.
Ooh.
42. Boop.
So I can sell two, getting... Yeah, that'll work.
Okay, yellow.
Hmm. That just shot all my chances of jumping over you.
I think so.
All right. For that lumber camp, what is that? Stone and set.
Two food.
Yeah, you can get that.
So that's 6 points, right?
Yep.
I think that's probably the most I can get from what I can see. I'll do that.
Yeah, once I set up my little domain in Hamath, I should have just been grab copper, sell copper, grab copper, sell copper, grab copper, sell copper. It's only 6 points a turn, though. Because copper never goes up in value.
Now, one of the things that we did before is every time one of those tiles came out at the beginning, we raised that same resource in the market.
Because there was a scarcity?
Yeah, something like that. But it was a little fiddly for what it was, but I don't know.
I think having different buy-sell values for the market would be valuable. It's like selling is always more valuable than buying.
Yeah.
Because you're not paying anyone.
We had sort of had that too, and we kind of convinced it down, but yeah, I'm not convinced that that's not needed.
Like, you can always buy gold for two or something. Like gold might always cost three. And then the red and blue cost two each, and then one for each of the other ones, always. But then, like, you still have that selling stuff.
Yeah.
Okay. Tony, what do you got?
I think the best action is to earn 12 points selling copper. It's technically only 9 points because I'm losing 3 points, but I think it's the most points I can get. Grabbing 4 blue cubes doesn't do much. The fortune cards could be worth more, but I don't feel like gambling. Menorah, everybody spent all their resources, so it doesn't matter. So yeah, selling 3 copper for 12. Yeah, I won't get lapped. I also won't hit 100, but I won't get lapped. I might hit 100.
All right. So, Tony, that's the end of the game. So, Tony, what extra points do you have?
So, for tribute cards, or for fortune cards, I have these three from my hand, which are 3, 5, and another 3 for 11, if my math is correct. And then 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 more points for resources.
You passed 100.
Yay.
Woohoo!
Okay, so red.
I can see red for now. And now he's going to leave me in the dust.
8 points on 2 cards. And then I've got another 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 points. Oh. What the hell?
Where did your tracker go?
Like, oh, there we go.
It's in your hand.
It went into your...
Yeah, because it turned sideways. So I was like, what the hell?
So I got to wave to you before you went around the corner.
Bye!
Later, guys. I'll just be hanging over here in the copper slums.
So, yeah, Rob, what do you got?
I don't have any cards, just...
So you get 5.
5.
2, 3, 4, 5. And I do have at least the one, but then I also have...
Oh, weaked out.
I also have these guys.
Couple 2-3.
So... I have 7 more points on top of that.
Very nice.
Nice even 150.
Nice. And the funny thing is I didn't build any roads. I just threw out a couple houses, and I concentrated on just using these foundries and the armory. I was trying to get another armory, but I didn't make my move soon enough.
You actually did almost kind of catch up there.
Because I was just thinking, you know what, if I can get the resources I need, I'm not going to, you guys just keep, you know, pounding up what you got over here. I'm just going to keep buying on these, but I should have done it a turn sooner.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Just like I should have abandoned everything. Once I got those two roads built, it should have just been nothing but buy, sell, buy, sell, buy, sell, buy, sell, because nobody else was getting copper. So I could have just sold 3 copper every other man for the rest of the game.
And I really wasn't, until you started talking endgame, I didn't even realize that we were almost at the end game. I was like, oh crap, I should have done that a turn sooner.
But
that's how you learn, though.
Yep.
That was pretty neat.
Yeah. So, Philip, what do you want to know?
Oh, well, I think it still seems like maybe it's a little bit longer than it should be, and maybe part of that's just Tabletopia, but I thought you guys played pretty quickly, so I don't know, thinking about
Tabletopia, from what I will say, I've played a couple of different games. It'll stretch an hour game into an hour and a half or 2 hours just dealing with the interface.
Yeah, so maybe that's not too far off, I don't know.
But...
Well, also, you were explaining the game, too, so that added a
little bit. Yes.
That's true.
And we had a little bit of a late start, too.
Mm-hmm. I mean, an easy way to accelerate the game is just to reduce the amount of resources that you have to pay to get stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Or just cut houses down by one.
Yeah, that's true.
That's kind of what I was thinking.
That would probably be better. And it's better for you to reduce its components.
Mm-hmm.
My biggest critique is the market. The market needs to be fixed.
Yeah, I agree. I agree.
And in terms of layout, I already mentioned this earlier, but don't have those lines. It's a little bit awkward.
Which lines are you talking about?
Here, let's zoom in a little bit. These guys.
Okay.
The line that goes underneath.
Okay.
Because it's awkward. What I would recommend is just have a box here, an outline, with all the spots inside.
Yeah, like a grid.
Yeah.
Sure.
Like, same thing here, because it looks like you have to go along this line, but it's a little bit...
Yeah, it looks like you're trapped.
I see what you're saying, like it's some kind of... Yeah, all right, I didn't think about that. Yeah. No, that's a good point.
Now, something like that could work for the house spaces to increase understanding that they process left or right.
Yes, yeah, that wouldn't be a bad idea to have them like that. Well, you can't put an arrow in there, but you can just
Right.
There's got to be a better thing for this too. I'm not happy with this iconography here.
Yeah, I agree with that too.
Blue cubes are crazy good.
Yeah, but I like how few of them there are.
Yeah, but they are good, but they're also, they're not over. They're not OP because they're not a ton of them.
No. I don't think they're OP. I think they're not being a ton of them is a problem. Like, if you're in first place or you're ahead on points and you grab the blue cubes, changing your turn order is largely irrelevant. Like, it's the reward. In the old game, it used to be you just got victory points based on how much you moved ahead. And in this, you get a resource, and if that resource is gone, you get nothing but earlier turn.
That's very punishing. I had to wait.
Is good. Yeah, is good, but maybe there were 3 rounds again where there were no blue cubes for me.
Yeah. Maybe take.
I don't know. I like the implementation of the blue cubes. Like, I really like them existing. As a wild.
Oh, here's the
thought. They replaced, the old trader and stuff.
I don't know how much this would complicate things, but have only 2 blue cubes to start the game.
And then each round you add one, or...?
No, so when someone takes incense, they grab blue cubes from the box.
Oh, so that way it brings them in.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. That's a good idea.
at the start of the game, there's only one blue cube available, so whoever takes Sinai, that's it. And if they hold on to it, they hold on to it. But the other way to get it is to have incense. And once the blue cubes are in the game, they're in the game.
Mm-hmm. Well, here's a question. Before, when I think it was Ian was going to pay off all those food to be able to build that last temple space there, this card I had thought about playing, the tax collector, and it says, choose a resource type. All players, including you, must return to the resource to display. Do you have to have that resource that you're calling to be turned in?
No, you don't have to have it.
So you could have nothing and everybody else could have it, and you can make everybody else cough up and you don't have to do anything. Okay.
Yep.
Because that's what I had thought about after you did that. I was like, damn, I could have drew that out a little longer by taking two away from you. I don't know if you still had enough to do it or not.
I don't think I did.
Yeah, because I noticed it after the fact. I was like, damn it.
Yeah, the merchant, I think the merchant just needs to be reworked a little bit, and that will change the game significantly because it will become a more valuable spot.
Great. Yeah.
But yeah, I think incense, it makes sense thematically as well because you're bringing it in from afar as an exotic good. Mm-hmm. So, but once it's in Israel, it's there forever. It's just traded amongst everyone.
I like that idea. It's kind of cool. Now, here's a question for you, and this is something that's been irking me. I hate how Tony was like behind the whole time, and really there was just no way for him to catch up, and we sort of talked about different ways to do it, and it's, I don't know. How would you feel about this game if you didn't have a score track and it was just like Puerto Rico where you just have some little chips that nobody knows exactly how many points you have?
This game is fiddly enough as it is. if you want to do it that way, it's fine, but so like Lords of Waterdeep, this is the closest that I can come to it, where there's secret points, but you want to try to have as many of those, if you're going to include those, have as many as you can, because then the person in last place might actually have a decent amount of points saved up.
Mm-hmm.
So, I don't know how you do it in this game. Because really, the fortune cards.
I mean,
are the only
I started in first, and migrated to the back, and I'm the only one who didn't take the turn order action.
Hmm.
Everybody else took it at least once.
Well, that's a good point.
So, don't think it's necessarily the game, but it did feel like I didn't have much that I could do.
Have you ever played
like,
it
I even had
points?
No, I haven't.
Might be worth trying it, you know.
Yeah.
Be easy enough to do.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, I even had a card in my hand that was, that let me change all the resources I collect this round into blue resources. And there was never a good time to play it until it was way too late for it to matter.
But
it was better as 3 points in my hand.
But if we had that rule where we had a lot of blue cubes, but you only start with one, and they come into the game through various points, and incense is one of them, having that fortune is actually good now, because it's like all of a sudden all your stuff is wild.
Mm-hmm.
It's a large injection of blue cubes.
But yeah, it just, it felt like that card, well, this is going to be 3 points at the end of the game. It doesn't help that it turns all the cubes that you collect into blue. And there's only so many blue, so I was collecting, you know, 7-8 cubes with one man. There aren't even 7 blue cubes in the game, so.
Well, I like the fact that you can, there's multiple ways of actually scoring, like I did. Like, these guys all up here were going and building roads and picking up a ton of resources. And if you can build these other buildings, like the armory and a foundry, they're huge right there. If you get both foundries, that's 28 points right there. Two armories.
Every round.
Oh, yeah.
Every round. If you were to do that, you can theoretically put out 48 points a round.
Yeah, I built a stables, and it was 7 points for two food.
Well, you're not going to get 48 points because you're not going to have enough resources, most likely, but every other round of it.
But yeah, with the copper being the way it was, I could get And the bazaar that I had that gave me plus one on cells. Even with copper buried, I could get 12 points every other guy, which on good turns was 36 points, on bad turns was 24 points.
Yeah.
So 50 points every two rounds, basically. Mm-hmm. Yeah, which...
This was like an exploration thing. Now looking back, we see those things. And you go, okay, next time you can min-max it, just go, okay, let's just go for this, and I'm just going to keep hammering out for points every other round.
Oh, yeah. I'm just going to hammer out all copper and nothing but copper. Like, yeah. I was largely unchallenged in that, in this, but I didn't exploit it as hard as I could have.
That's why I was happy when you were selling. I was like, yeah, you're putting it back in there. I need that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think shortening the game a little bit might be valuable, though.
Mm-hmm.
Regardless, reduce the temple by two, and then decrease the number of houses by one each.
Yeah.
I think that would just be a good way to really slow things, speed things up.
Well, if you reduce the temple by two, do you also reduce the Levite spaces by one? Or do you still give people the option to build three in a turn?
Yeah, I don't want it to be over in three rounds, I don't think.
Right,
it won't be.
No, I don't think it will be. You're right.
Yeah, because of the cost of the temple, you literally cannot.
No.
No, but I think five is a possibility.
How many rounds did we play doing it? Anybody know?
I was sort of trying to keep track. I think it was seven.
Well, we recorded this, so we can always go through and check.
Yeah.
So it would probably cut it down at least one, if not two rounds.
Yeah. Because, mm-hmm. I mean, you don't really build the temple until, like, the third, fourth round, once you've got a couple roads down.
Well, you can look at it this way, too. I mean, the way that the game ended with Ian and then Rob, and it's like everybody's position didn't really change very much in the last three rounds.
Mm-mm. No, that's true.
It should have ended three rounds ago and it'd been the same result.
And then everyone would have been closer and Tony wouldn't have felt as bad.
So, no,
he was still pretty.
I don't feel bad. I would have actually been further behind.
Yeah.
If it had ended three rounds earlier, I wouldn't have been making points from copper yet.
Tony wishes we could play for the next five rounds. No.
Not quite that bad, like as long as nobody gets to go to the menorah, sure. I'll just eventually take all of the resources. And then
that's another thing I wanted to ask. Did you think the menorah does anything, or is it just a big?
It's not as valuable. I took it because everyone had a ton of cubes, and I had it was good for me because it was a net gain for me, no matter what.
Right. Now we had originally made that as you lose one for every cube that you have, and that was pretty brutal.
That's devastating.
Yeah. Oh, totally.
So like the whole game was about that, which was ridiculous. So I don't know. I don't know if that's
You might want to do is provide a base number of points. So based on number of players, it's tough because iconography is so difficult. But giving some point bonus, just like a base point bonus, because none of these just give you points right off the bat.
Mm-hmm.
The Ark kind of does, but...
Yeah, the Ark kind of does. The table technically does.
Yeah.
It gives you 5 points.
But and the incense technically does as well. So I would say...
can give you up to four.
I would say putting, get 7 points for the menorah. Like, it's a quick little thing and it's done. Actually, I would say five. 5 points. Seven seems... I don't know why seven seems more than... It should. It does.
Let me see something here. It should have nine.
9 points?
Because that's how many a menorah actually has.
That's actually really clever and cute.
I don't know how to make the math work, but I was just thinking that.
That one has seven. Well, that one has seven.
Yeah.
Well, then 7 points. There you go. Yeah, no, that's thematic. I would say, yeah, keep it to that. And then it's still valuable, even if people aren't don't have very many cubes. So it's still an option to get points at the end of the game. Or during the game, really. Mm-hmm. It's like, I get 7 points. Oh, and wow, everyone else has a ton of cubes, so they lose a ton. Woo! So it's,
yeah, seven.
It's a little catch-up mechanic.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I like that.
Yeah. Seven isn't like a game-breaking amount of points either. It's like the least amount of points you can get for building on the temple.
Well, also keep in mind that it will likely equal about 10 points, give or take, depending on when you play it. The arc is worth, I would say each one of those is worth 10 points by themselves.
Yes.
Aha. So we're both right. The 9-branched candelabrum lit during Hanukkah is 9. The 7-branched menorah was used in the ancient temple, so 7 would be appropriate for this time period. Okay. 9 is what they use now.
Yeah, good deal.
So there you go.
Yeah, Phil, I would actually say that 10 is a pretty decent idea, because the fortune cards give small bonuses. Like small point, well, you guys seem to get higher point values. I only got ones and threes. But the power of those cards approximately equals about 10. And then incense, going first, like, it might not seem like you have a lot of advantage, but you really do.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
I mean, I noticed, like, wow, I feel like I actually can do something right out the gate when I was going first.
Oh, yeah, discounting the power of going first and looking at it exclusively for the blue cubes is the wrong way to look at it, I think. Right. There's just not a very good way to communicate that. I think the proposed change of incense entering the game that way makes it clearer that getting turn order is the important part of it.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, there were very few times where you guys blocked me out. Like, I didn't play in the pieces of the board you were in, so, like, you weren't blocking my worker from doing things, but you would often buy buildings before I could.
Yeah. The table is also worth 10 points just because of the diversity it gives you.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, five different goods gives you a lot of options over here. You can buy almost any building based on that alone. So it's valuable because of its very diversity.
Yeah, you may need one other worker, but you'll already have done that.
Right.
Do you think there are too many spaces, or does it feel about right?
I think that you actually want to pull more of these tiles. Yeah. 3 did not feel very punishing. It was like, oh, darn. Because if we had... Here, let's just pull out a couple more. Hamath. Ooh, sorry, Tony.
Well, had I not gotten the card that let me gain resources from places that weren't producing this turn, I would have been completely out of the game.
See, now it's like, oh, okay. Yeah. And are there one of each of the four?
Yeah, there's just one. Yeah, there's one of each.
I would include one trader. I would include.
It is.
3 merchants.
Hmm.
Like I would include more so that they cover up more, so it dilutes this a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
But so there's when this comes out, who cares?
Yeah, right. There are five more spaces.
This is the first time we played with those action ones mixed in.
And same thing with the foreman. Like, having one gone is not that bad, but having 2 or 3 gone, now it's all of a sudden different.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Or how about if they just block out that action altogether instead of just...
That's really painful.
No, that's... I would say that that's almost too hurtful, especially if you want to speed the game along. If you block the foreman... Right. It completely blocks that whole turn.
Yeah, and because it's random, you could have the foreman blocked multiple turns in a row.
Mm-hmm.
Well, then you would just need one, right?
Well, it's...
You wouldn't need more than one foreman block, for example, or trader or merchant.
I just feel like right now there's so many territory blocks that the other ones really don't matter all that much. Is there a traitor one?
There is.
Okay. Is that included in the two-player game?
Yes.
Oh, okay, so you could block that off completely. Hmm. Yeah, I would consider adding more of those, more of the action ones, at least.
But yeah, I think the traitor existing also really weakens the value of blue cubes. Not that they need to be stronger, just...
I liked how the traitor worked in this game. It worked about like I was hoping it would. Because
right.
before it was like a one-for-one thing, and it was pretty useless.
Yeah, I think the market is definitely the place to focus the attention. Everywhere else, like speeding it up a little bit makes sense. Yeah, I'm trying to think of anything else we haven't hit on. Hoarding resources is fun. I still like the fact that the resources are limited.
Yeah, that seemed to work pretty well.
No, that created the tension in this game.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It gave me something to do other than dwell on how far behind I was. If I could have done something with them, like if I had gotten an armory or I had gotten more buildings that let me spend them better than the market. Because it seems like all of the buildings, like the stables that I have is 2 food for 7 points. You're never going to get that from the market. The best you could get, I don't know if there are 2 of the bazaars that increase your sell, but the best you're going to get is 4 points per...
Right.
Okay, guys. I hate to put a damper on this, but it is 12:30.
Yes, it is time. It is time.
We need to call this right now. But if anyone ends up watching this, I hope you learned something. I hope you enjoyed the playthrough. And I'll leave this up permanently, Philip, so you can go back and look through it.
So it's just that same link.
It should be. I'll make sure that that's the case. So I'm going to stop broadcast now.
Okay. All right. Thanks, guys. I really appreciate it.